made the first visit so surprising was to learn how ordinary Henny's life was before the war.
She was just like any other typical teen nowadays, focused on school, sports, friends, and even her accordion that unfortunately she never got a chance to learn how to play. As a kid, she was so innocent, yet Hitler stole her childhood.
They kill every day, they killed. You didn't have a bed for yourself anymore. You had 12 in one bunk bed. Quite often they blow you. After a while, you were afraid to get close. You lost everybody.
Hearing her voice, watching her every move with the way she expressed herself and her past as a whole had us all take a step back and realize and appreciate the things that we have that Henny could never get back in her childhood.
She showed her perseverance, hope, and strength and came out strong and positive. She set an example for who we should be by describing her brutal experiences, but always left us with a positive mindset and outcome.
If you have to, you can do anything.
Unfortunately for all Holocaust survivors, including Henny, the world didn't stop turning after liberation. Even after years of horror, Henny had to jump right back into work.
Oh, you have no idea what a mess it is after a war. The first time after 3.5 years, I had a white tablecloth on the table. I had a table to sit at, and a white tablecloth and food on it.
Unfortunately, even after liberation, Henny still wasn't free.
That guy heard us, my girlfriend Putti, and I, we were speaking German. That was our language. He pulled his gun. He said, Germans. And he wanted to kill us. After a week, they told us, you better go a little bit further away from the front lines because it's war. As a matter of fact, I'll never forget this. We were standing there and talking. One German guy walks by and says, they should have gassed you all. That was the mindset at that time.
One of the things that surprised me the most out of this experience was hearing how Henny received hate mail. It blew my mind the fact that people actually denied that the Holocaust even happened or that it wasn't as bad as history remembers, even after all that she'd been through. But to no surprise, she handled it. She said it motivated her to share her story even more. Henny, Benny, and along with other Holocaust survivors can attest after this tragic event of mass genocide that we're all part of the same race, the human race.
And the most important thing is perseverance. Never give up. That's my mantra, never give up.
Henny was a very special and inspirational woman who touched me on a very personal level. It is not an easy task to put into words all that she was as we came to know her. It's not just recounting the life of someone in the room, it's describing the essence of a heroine who is no longer with us. Before fighting for her life became an everyday challenge, and before running through gunfire and fences for a box of Farina, Henny was a teenager like most of us, playing sports and teasing strangers. Having to relive the pain of her horrific experiences in stolen childhood took tremendous courage, but she chose to do it again and again for the sake of our generation and those to come. She told her story with the hopes that the Holocaust would never be forgotten or disproven, and to ensure that it never happens again. In recounting her experiences, she taught as many as she could reach to treat others with kindness. Her greatest lesson to me was perseverance, to never give up. It's without doubt that this sweet, strong woman touched the lives of each person she encountered. I feel very fortunate to have known Henny Simon and to have heard her story.
In loving memory of Henny, she had always said, never give up.